UnrealCEFSubProcess.exe, causing high CPU and memory usage even after closing Valorant? Here are 5 ways you can fix it. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research trying to find the working solutions for you. This way you can stay connected with us and get quick help with your future tech issues. Now, let's get started. Method 1. The first thing you need to do is uninstall or disable any third-party antivirus you have. Press the Windows plus R keys to open Run. Type appviz.cpl and press Enter. Look for the third-party antivirus you have installed and right-click on them. Select Uninstall. Follow the on-screen instructions and once it finishes, restart your PC. Make sure to uninstall AVJ, Avast, McAfee or any other third-party antivirus. Method 2. If you don't want to uninstall or disable the antivirus, then add the UnrealCEFSubProcess.exe in their exclusion list. Those who are using Windows Defender, here is how you can do it. First, right-click on the Valorant desktop shortcut and select Open File Location. Click on the Riot Games folder from the address bar. Now open the Valorant folder. Open the Live folder. Next, open the Engine folder and then open the Binaries folder. Open the Win64 folder. Remember the address of this folder. Now, type Windows Security in the search bar and select the top result. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down and click on Manage Ransomware Protection. Next, click on Allow an app through Controller Folder Access and select Yes. Click on Add an Allowed App option. Select Browse All Apps. Browse to the address shown earlier. Look for the UnrealCEFSubProcess file. Select it and add it. Now the issue should be fixed. Don't have a solution so far? After the video ends, join our Facebook group where our experts help users just like you solve tech issues every day. Join the group from the link in the description or the pinned comment and ask for help. We promise to help you out. Method 3. The next thing you can do is check if the VGC service is set to automatic. Type services in the search bar and select the top result. Look for the VGC service and right-click on it. Select the Properties option from the menu. Change the startup type to automatic and click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Restart your PC and see if the issue gets fixed. Method 4. The next thing you can try is reinstalling the Riot Vanguard. Type Control Panel in the search window and select the top result. Change the view by to large icons. Look for the Programs and Features option and click on it. Find the Riot Vanguard option and right-click on it. Select the Uninstall option. Follow as shown to complete the process. Once the uninstallation process finishes, restart Valorant. Now Valorant will install the Riot Vanguard, so wait for it to finish. Method 5. Temporary files store all the temporary data created by Windows and the programs. These cache files can sometimes become corrupted and conflict with your game. Because of this, you may get this issue. Try deleting the temporary files and see if that solves the error. Launch the Run dialog box by pressing Windows key plus R keys. Enter %10% in the Run command box and press the Enter key. Press Ctrl plus A to select all the files and click on the Delete button. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Join our Facebook group where you will get direct help on everything tech. Leave a comment and help others know which solutions solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and always remember that we are here to help you out.